the friends and welcome to another interesting and very useful video from Biostudies. Yes, this video is about the taxonomic hierarchy. Many students get confused to remember the taxonomic hierarchy. So this video is about the tricks to learn the taxonomic hierarchy. So please do watch the video till end so that you will be able to crack any questions related to the taxonomic hierarchy in the exams. Okay. Now first, what is a taxonomic hierarchy? I have made a separate video on the taxonomic hierarchy in detail with the suitable examples. Please check the description box for the related video link. Okay. It is the arrangement of taxonomic categories for organisms, and this hierarchy we use during biological classification. Now, which are the 7 main taxonomic categories that we use? The first one is kingdom. Okay. Second one is what? It is phylum, also referred as what? Division. Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and last one is what? It is the species. So these are the 7 main obligate categories that we use in a taxonomic hierarchy. Okay. Now we will study, I will give you main 5 tricks to remember this taxonomic hierarchy. Okay. Now we will take the first one. This is about how to remember the sequence of categories in the hierarchy, because many students get confused at this point whether the order will come first or the family will come first, or the family is followed by genus or genus is followed by family. So you can read the hierarchy in descending order or in ascending order, but you have to remember the sequence of categories, isn't it? So for this, the first trick is you have to remember the mnemonic. Now, what do you mean by mnemonic? M-N-E. Mnemonics or mnemonic, these are the memory tools that we use to remember certain things. Okay. For example, I'll give you here. Keep pond clean. Keep pond clean, or froggy gets sick. Very funny, isn't it? So keep pond clean or froggy gets sick. So what does this mean? In this mnemonic, K stands for what? Kingdom, then phylum, class, order, family, genus, and last one is species name. Okay, so remember this funny mnemonic, that is keep pond clean or froggy gets sick. Now there is one more very famous mnemonic about the sequence, that is King Philip, okay, came over from Great Spain. So this is also one trick. So this is also one mnemonic you can remember to know the sequence of categories. So what does this mean here? K stands for again kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. So these, either of these, you can remember one, which one you feel convenient, you can remember that mnemonic. Okay. So which are those? Keep pond clean or froggy get sick, or King Philip's came over from Great Spain. So if you remember these two mnemonics, you can remember the sequence. Okay. Now the second trick, number 2, this is about COF. What is COF? It is cough. We know this cough, C-O-U-G-H. What is this cough? When we expel the air from lungs with a great sound, like this is the cough, isn't it? But the cough word which we are referring here is COF. Now what is this COF? See, in the taxonomic categories of hierarchy, genus and species we are familiar because we have studied these two during binomial nomenclature. Okay. Kingdom and phylum is also very easy to remember. KP, that is kingdom and phylum. But many students get confused here to remember the sequence of class, order, and family. Most confusing categories. Okay. So you can correlate here. C stands for what? It is class. then order, then family. So what is this cough? Class, order, family. Then you can add genus and species here, and KP, that is kingdom and phylum. Okay, so remember COF, that is class, order, family. Okay, so this is the trick number 2. So these two first tricks are about to remember the sequence of taxonomic categories. Okay, now trick number 2, this is about whether to use the word phylum or division. So most of the time we have seen writing phylum or division when we write the hierarchy. But why there are two category names at this level of classification? Because the term phylum is usually used during animal classification. Okay, and division is usually used for plant classification or sometimes algae, classification of algae. So in the exam, they may give you one word and they will ask you whether this word is used for the animal classification or kingdom classification. So they can give you the options like kingdom, phylum, division and class. So if the question is for animal kingdom, you have to choose phylum. If the question is for plant kingdom, then you have to choose division. So this is the third trick about the taxonomic hierarchy. Okay, now next, fourth one, this is about the arrow marks. Now what are these arrow marks here? See, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So we have K here and species, S here. Okay, so kingdom and species. When you read the hierarchy from kingdom to species, that is in descending order, this indicates the increasing similarity. What is this similarity? The common characters among the organisms. Okay, so when you read the hierarchy in a descending order, this indicates the increasing similarity. Okay, but when you read the hierarchy, so again K and S, when you read it in an ascending order, this indicates the decreasing similarity. Okay, so even you have a question based on this point in your exemplar textbook also. So when you read it in a descending order, it increases the similarity. When you read it in an ascending order, this indicates the decreasing similarity. Okay, so the common characters, whether they will increase or decrease or they remain same, so that point is depending on whether you are reading it in an ascending order or descending order. So remember, the arrow should be always opposite to each other. Okay, so descending order, increasing similarity; ascending order, decreasing similarity. Okay, so this is the fourth trick. Now fifth last trick, which is very important, but try to understand, bit confusing, but we'll make it very easy here. The fifth trick is, this is about the suffix that we use in the words. For example, we know about prefix and suffix. What are these prefix and suffixes? Any words that we use at the beginning of the word, we call it as a prefix. And any letters that we use at the end of the word, that we call it as a suffix. Okay, now this trick is about the suffix. Okay, for example, now division, okay, then class, then order and family. Okay, now remember, any word which is ending with AE, this indicates the name of the division. What is this division? Division is the level of classification at the phylum level. So division, any word ending with AE, it refers the name of the division. Okay, any word which is ending with ONAE, this is the name of the class. Okay, any word which is ending with ALES as the suffix, this is the order name. And last one, A-C-E-A-E. So any word which is ending with A-C-A, it is the name of the family. Now I'll give you an example to understand this trick. Okay. Now there is one word called angiosperma. Okay. Now what is this angiosperma? Now look at this word. The word ending with A-E. So A-E means what? A-E is the name of the division. So in the exam, they may give you this word and they may ask you to identify whether this name is the category at division or class or order or family level. What is the answer? You have to look for its suffix. So the word ending with A-E is what? It is the division. Okay. We'll give you a few more examples here. Dicotyledone. Okay. Now see here. Dicotyledone. What is the suffix? O-N-A-E. So O-N-A-E. That means what? It is dicotyledone is the name of the class. Now name the plant which belongs to the class Dicotyledone. It is the mango. Okay. One more example. Monocotyledone. So again, what is the suffix here? O-N-A-E. So Monocotyledone is also the name of the class. And the plant that belongs here is the wheat. Okay. Just remember. So Dicotyledone and Monocotyledone, since they are ending with O-N-A-E, these two are the names of the class. Okay. Then we'll take few more. Sapindales. Now see the suffix here. A-L-E-S. So A-L-E-S. So Sapindales is the name of one order. And the plant that belongs here is mango. So mango belongs to order Sapindales. One more. Poales. What is this poales? A-L-E-S. Again, poales is the order to which the wheat belongs. Okay. So any words that are ending with A-L-E-S, these are the names of order. Okay. Last one is family. Anacardiaceae. Now here I will take Anacardiaceae. Okay, so A-C-E-A-E means what? It is the family name. So Anacardiaceae is the family to which mango belongs. Poaceae. So this is the family to which the wheat belongs. Okay, so based on the suffix name, you can identify whether that name is a division or class or order or family. So have you observed one thing here? I have not used phylum. I have used division. That means what? Divisions means this is the plant classification. So whatever trick I have given here, these suffixes, these are mainly used for plant classification. Remember, this trick is especially for the plant classification, and majority of the times classification of plants is used in your exam from the first chapter, that is the living word. Okay. So you had to remember the suffix. Then how about the animal family? In animal family, animal classification. Okay. Now only one trick I can give you, that is for the family. Okay. So it always ends with A-E. Okay. Example, hominidae. Now what is this hominidae? The word ending with A-E means family. Hominidae is the family to which man belongs. Then felidae. So felidae is the family to which the cat or the tiger or lion, the big cat belongs. Okay. Next, canidae or canidae. So canidae is the family to which dog and wolf or jackal, such type of animal belongs to family canidae. So in case of animal classification, the family name can be recognized with the suffix AE. Don't get confused. In case of animal classification, AE refers to a family name. But in case of plant classification, AE refers to the division. Okay. So these are the 5 super easy tricks to learn the taxonomic hierarchy. Okay. So first 2 are about the mnemonics. Then next one is about cough. Third is about phylum or division. Then fourth one, arrows, which are always in opposite directions. And fifth one is about the suffix for plant classification, and only one suffix for the animal classification. I hope this video will be really very useful for you to crack the question on taxonomic hierarchy. We'll meet you again with a very interesting and very useful video in the next section. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you for watching.